स्टूडेंट गुड मॉर्निंग सो यस्टरडे वीडियो वी हैव लर्न व्हाट इज मीन बाय वुड्स रिएक्शन व्हाट आर देयर लिमिटेशंस एंड व्हाट आर देयर एग्जांपल्स सो द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल्स ऑफ वुड्स रिएक्शन एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व द एमसीक्यू ऑफ वुड्स रिएक्शंस दैट वी विल सी टुडे सो अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ वुड्स रिएक्शन दैट इज नेसेसरी इज सो व्हेन this isopropyl chloride is treated with sodium metal in the presence of dry ether so you know that in the Wood's reaction there are two same alkyl halide should be reacted so the alkyl halide is so this is the CH3 this CH3 and this H so this isopropyl chloride two molecules of isopropyl chloride on treated with sodium metal in the presence of dry ether okay heat it so this is called as isopropyl chloride right okay so this is the isopropyl group chlorine is attached so therefore it is called as isopropyl chloride right then what is the IUPAC name numbering should be started from here so therefore at second carbon atom chlorine is there 2-chloropropane right okay so this is the 2-chloropropane when this 2-chloropropane on treatment with sodium metal in the presence of dry ether as you know that this is a coupling reaction two alkyl halide get coupled with each other so what will be the product so product will be so this is the CH3 this CH3 H right then this carbon carbon form a new bond so there is a formation of bond between this two carbon then this is the CH3 as it is this CH3 as it is this H right okay then what is the IUPAC name 1, 2, 3, 4 right so what is the IUPAC name 2, 3 at 2 carbon and at 3 carbon there are 2 methyl group so therefore 2,3-dimethyl 1, 2, 3, 4 then that is the butane straight chain right and elimination of 2 molecules of sodium chloride right okay this is the product so this is the branched chain example of Wood's reaction we will see another example again suppose I have the straight chain example of this n propyl chloride or 1-chloropropane so this is the propyl chloride okay then what is the IUPAC name IUPAC name numbering should be started from that end of the carbon atom in which halogen atom should be attached 1, 2, 3 so therefore what is the IUPAC name 1-chloropropane right this is the 1-chloropropane so two molecules of 1-chloropropane so another molecule so this is the CH2 CH2 CH3 right okay then right okay so in the presence of dry ether heat it so this is a coupling reaction as you know very well so there is a formation of bond between this molecule of n propyl chloride carbon and another molecule of n propyl chloride carbon so there is a formation of new bond between these two carbon atom so how we can write it so then this is the CH3 as it is then this CH2 okay this CH2 okay there is a formation of bond between these two carbon atom so this new bond is formed right okay then CH2 CH2, CH3. Okay. So how many carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is the N-hexane. Okay. N-hexane is produced and these two molecules of NaCl is separated. Right. Okay. So this is the another example of Wood's reaction. Okay. So again you can take the another examples, right? Okay. So four example you have to do for the practice at your home. These are the theoretical examples. Let us take how the MCQ will ask on this part. Okay. So I will write the two to three examples of this MCQ so we can solve the problem, then you will get the practice very well and you can understand this topic easily. Okay, so what is the question? So question is identify X in the following reaction. Identify X in the following reactions. Okay, so what is the reaction? So reaction is this one iodobutane, right? So this one iodobutane, then sodium metal, dry ether, here heat gives the X. So question is like this. How to solve this question? See, identify X in the following reaction. So reaction is given. So what is given in the reaction? 1-iodobutane. So you know that in the Wood's reaction, two same molecules of alkyl halide should be reacted with each other. Hence, 1-iodobutane, write the molecular formula and structural formula of 1-iodobutane. So CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Right, this is the N-butyl group. Okay, then iodine is attached. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right, okay. So therefore, this is called as commonly N-butyl iodide. This is the common name. What is the IUPAC name? IUPAC name 1-iodobutane. This is the IUPAC name 1-iodobutane. Right, okay. So then it is treated with the sodium metal. So therefore, this is the CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, right? Okay. So this is again the 1-iodobutane, because in the Wood's reaction, two same molecules of alkyl iodide should react with the sodium metal in the presence of dry ether. That is the Wood's reaction. So hence, this is the dry ether. Okay, heat it. So this is a coupling reaction. Right? Okay. So they get coupled with each other. So what is the final product? So final product is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Right. So this is written. There is a formation of new bond between this alkyl halide group and this alkyl halide group carbon. So there is a carbon-carbon bond. So this CH2, there is a formation of bond, right? So this CH2, 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 and this is the CH3, right? Okay. So how many carbon atoms are in the straight chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. How many carbon? 8 carbon atoms are there. So therefore, if the 8 carbon atom is there, then the carbon atom are in the straight chain. So then it is the N octane, right? Plus, what is to be separated out? Sodium iodide. Okay. So this is the question. So hence, this question, this is the solution. So this is the solution. So X is equal to this CH3, CH2, CH2. How many times? 8 carbon atoms are there. So therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this 7 and this 8. So therefore, this is the N octane. Right? Okay. So question is like this. Suppose, again question is asked in this way. This is the टर्शरी ब्यूटील ब्रोमाइड. राइट, ओके. सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज सॉल्व. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सपोज टर्शरी ब्यूटील ब्रोमाइड इज हीटेड विथ सोडियम मेटल इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई एथर, व्हाट विल बी द एक्स. राइट, ओके. इफ द क्वेश्चन विल आस्क लाइक दिस, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. व्हाट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन? टर्शरी ब्यूटील क्लोराइड इज द अल्किल हैलाइड गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. सो टर्शरी ब्यूटील क्लोराइड हीटेड विद सोडियम मेटल इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई एथर गिव द एक्स, एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द एक्स. हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन? सो अगेन राइट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ टर्शरी ब्यूटील क्लोराइड. So we can write the structure of tertiary butyl chloride, CH3, CH3, CH3. You know that. What is the name of this alkyl group? Tertiary butyl group. Right? Okay, we have studied already the alkyl group. So hence, this is the tertiary butyl group. What is to be attached? Chlorine. Then it becomes tertiary butyl chloride. This is the tertiary ब्यूटील क्लोराइड, इज अ टर्शरी ब्यूटील क्लोराइड. राइट, ओके. देन दिस इज ट्रीटेड विद द सोडियम मेटल इन द वुड्स रिएक्शन टू सेम मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ अल्किल हैलाइड मस्ट बी रिएक्टेड. सो देयरफॉर दिस इज अगेन द नेक्स्ट मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ टर्शरी ब्यूटील क्लोराइड. ओके, वी हैव रिटन. Then what is to be given? Sodium metal is given. Then this should be treated in the presence of dry ether as a solvent. Dry ether is used as a solvent. So dry ether, that is, it is free from the moisture. So that is the dry ether. If moisture is there, what will happen? Sodium metal react with the moisture and there will not be the formation of symmetrical alkane or higher alkane. So therefore we always use solvent should be dry ether. Okay, then we know that this is a coupling reaction. So what is the product? So this CH3, then this is the CH3 as it is. So then there is a formation of bond between these two carbon atoms. So hence newly bond is formed between these two carbon atoms. So this CH3 is as it is. You write this CH3, this is the CH3, okay, plus 2NaCl. Right, okay, this is the final product. So what is the name of this compound? So select the longest continuous chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, 2, 3, 4, any one of the chain you can select, because any one if you select, there must be the only four carbon atom in the straight chain. Right, okay. Then at two carbon atom, how many methyl group? Two methyl group. So these two for this methyl group, these two for this methyl group. Then at three carbon atom, how many methyl groups are there? Two methyl groups are there. So these three for this methyl group, these three for this methyl group. How many carbon atoms are there? How many alkyl groups are there? Four. So therefore, which alkyl groups are there? Methyl. So therefore, four alkyl group, tetra. The name of the group, methyl. How many carbon atoms are there? Four. So 2, 2, 3, 3, tetramethyl butane is the product. Right? Okay. So hence, X is equal to, this is the solution. Now you have to write the X, identify the X. So X will be this CH3, this CH3, this CH3, and this CH3. Okay, this is the X product. Okay, so MCQ you have to solve like this. Okay, another MCQ, we will see how the MCQ will be set in the NEET or JEE exam. Okay, so what is the questions? So we will see the next question. So question will be, which of the following? So third question, which of the following metal Which of the following metal is used in Wood's reaction? Which of the following metal is used in Wood's reaction? For example, the multiple choice questions are, this is the magnesium. So multiple options. Then zinc, then sodium metal, then D option will be potassium metal. Okay, so what is the question? Which of the following metal is used in the Wood's reaction? You know that. Which metal we used in Wood's reaction? Sodium metal. So therefore, answer will be this one. Right? Okay. So therefore, question may be arises like this. Suppose, next question. Which of the following alkene do not produce in Wood's reaction? Okay, so this is the question. Then what are the multiple options? Is this ethane, then this B is N butane, then this C is N hexane, right? Okay, and D will be this propane, right? Okay, so therefore, question is like this: which of the following alkene do not produce in Wood's reaction? Okay, we know that Wood's reaction is used to prepare the higher alkene containing even number of carbon atom or symmetrical alkene containing even number of carbon atom. So this is the hint. What is the hint for this question? If you know the hint of the questions easily, then solution will be solved within a fraction of seconds. Okay, so therefore, if you read the question carefully, after reading the question, you recall it. Okay, after recalling, you should understood the trick of the question. Then once you know the trick, what is the trick of this question? And what will be the hint of this question? The hint of the question is Wood's reaction are used for the symmetrical alkene containing the even number of carbon atom. Okay, so then which do not produce then? This ethane contain how many carbon atom? So CH3, two carbon atom. So therefore, it is a carbon atom of even number of alkane. This alkane is a carbon atom of even number, CH3, CH2, CH3. This is the structure of N-butane. How many carbon atoms are present in the straight chain? Four carbon atoms are there. Then N hexane. What is the structure of N hexane? CH3, CH2. This CH2 and CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many carbon atoms are there? 6 carbon atoms are there. Right. Next is the propane. CH3. Okay. How many carbon atoms are there? 3 carbon atoms are there. Then what is our hint? The odd number of carbon atom should not be produced by the Wood's reaction. Okay, so therefore this alkene is a carbon containing odd number, so therefore this will not produce in the Wood's reaction. So what will be the answer? This is the answer. Okay, so see how many variety of questions will be asked, isn't it? Sometime predict the product or identify the product, then which metal is used, right? Then which of the following alkene do not produce in the Wood's reaction, right? Okay, again another example we will take. Okay, so what will be the example? So which of the following catalyst or Which of the following solvent is used in Wood's reaction? okay, which of the following solvent is used in Wood's reaction? This is the question. So how many multiple options? Four multiple options. What are that multiple option? A, so that is the water. Then B, soda lime, that you know soda lime. Okay, then C will be the acetone, that is the ethanol, you can write. So ethanol, okay, and D will be the dry ether, right? Okay, so this is a very easy question. Which of the following solvent, so this is the fourth question, which of the following solvent is used in the Wood's reaction? Which solvent generally we use? Dry ether. Why we use the dry ether? The dry ether is free from the moisture. If the moisture is present, that sodium metal react with the moisture. Moisture is nothing but the water and produce the sodium hydroxide. So therefore, in the Wood's reaction, ether must be dry. So therefore, what is the answer? This is the answer, that is the dry ether. Okay, so you have to solve such a questions in the MCQ book that we have displayed this book on your app. So you go through that book and you solve all the questions arises from this Wood's reaction. Okay, so have you understood? So once you know the theoretical part easily, once you know the hints, so you can solve the any questions. Okay, so therefore this is regarding the Wood's reaction. So this is the third preparation. Now the fourth preparation is we have to study. So last preparation of alkane, that is from the unsaturated hydrocarbon. So this is regarding the Wood's reaction. Okay, so you read the NCERT book, then you solve the MCQ type questions, that is the book that has been already displayed on the app. So you solve all the questions, and if you arises any doubt, you can ask me. I have given my personal mobile number to you also. Okay, so this is the preparation of alkane from Wood's reaction. So last preparation, that is the fourth preparation, and that preparation is from unsaturated hydrocarbon. From unsaturated hydrocarbon, right? Okay, so you know that in the first topic, general organic chemistry, what is mean by unsaturated hydrocarbon? Those hydrocarbon which contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond is called as unsaturated hydrocarbon. Right, okay, so this is the definition of unsaturated hydrocarbon. So which unsaturated hydrocarbon you have seen in the first topic? Alkene, alkyne, because alkene contain the one double bond, whereas alkyne contain the two double bond, right? Okay, so this is the unsaturated hydrocarbon example, that is the ethylene. Okay, what is the name of this compound? This is the ethylene, right? So this ethylene contain one double bond. Suppose I am going to take the another example. Okay, so here this is called as ethyne. This is called as ethyne. Okay, IUPAC name, and common name is acetylene, right? Okay, so this ethylene or ethene, this is also called as the ethene. Okay, then this ethene or ethylene contain one double bond, whereas this acetylene or ethyne contain the two double bond, right? Okay, so one double bond, two double bond. So hence, at least one double bond is present in any hydrocarbon, that is the unsaturated hydrocarbon in the straight chain alkane. Actually, in the straight chain alkane, if you have one double bond or two double bond, such a hydrocarbon is called as unsaturated hydrocarbon. So simple examples are, so this ethylene, that is the acetylene, okay, propylene, propyne, butyne, pentyne, hexyne, all these are the examples. Okay, so have you understood what is mean by unsaturated hydrocarbon? Now we will see actual how the alkane is prepared from the unsaturated hydrocarbon. Okay, so First of all, if I want to prepare from the alkene, okay, so examples of alkene, okay, so what is the general reaction of alkene? So this is the carbon-carbon double bond, okay, so this is the alkene, right, okay. Then if the carbon-carbon triple bond, right, if you are going to write the structures of alkene and alkyne, first of all, whether the carbon atom valency is satisfied or not, you have to check it. Then check it here, 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the valency of carbon? 4 is the valency of carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, valency is satisfied. Here, this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, valency of carbon is satisfied. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, valency of carbon is satisfied, right, okay. So when both these alkene and alkyne, so this is the alkene, this is the alkyne, okay. So when this alkene and alkyne is hydrogenated, so from unsaturation hydrocarbon, what is the name of the process? Hydrogenation. Okay, so what is mean by hydrogenation? Hydrogen. Then hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen is called as hydrogenation. Right, okay. So what is mean by hydrogenation? As you know very well, addition of hydrogen molecule is called as hydrogenation. So therefore, when this alkene is heated with hydrogen gas, right, so this is the hydrogen gas. Similarly, alkyne is also heated with the hydrogen gas because both are unsaturated hydrocarbon. So this hydrogenation is carried out in the presence of catalyst, that is the Rani-Nikhil catalyst. Okay, so Rani is the name of the scientist who discovered this active nickel catalyst, so therefore it is called as Rani-Nikhil catalyst. Okay, so therefore this is the Rani-Nikhil catalyst. Okay, so temperature must be 453 to 473 Kelvin, right, okay. What is the temperature? Temperature will be 453 to 473 Kelvin. Similarly, here also, what is the catalyst? Rani-Nikhil catalyst, okay. Then temperature is same, 453 to 473 Kelvin. Right, okay. So as I told you that this is the hydrogenation process, okay. Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen molecule across this carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bond. See here one hydrogen molecule is required, here the two hydrogen molecule is required, okay. So therefore, what is the hydrogen molecule? So see here, carbon-carbon double bond is there, okay. So this hydrogen molecule, one hydrogen add to this carbon, another hydrogen add to this carbon, so therefore this pi bond is cancelled. So if the pi bond is cancelled, what will happen? So this is the hydrogen, right, okay. We have added the hydrogen molecule, so one pi bond is cancelled for the addition of one hydrogen molecule. How many pi bond are there here? Two pi bond. So therefore, two double bond, you can see here one double bond, one hydrogen molecule required, two double bond, two hydrogen molecule is required. So therefore, what will be the product? So here again the alkene will be the product, right, okay. So what you will get? You will get the alkene. So here you will get the again alkene, okay, right, okay. So this three valency indicate that hydrogen will be there, so hydrogen will be there, okay. So hence this reaction is called as Sabatier-Sanderson reaction. This is called as the Sabatier-Sanderson reaction, right, okay. So this process is called as hydrogenation. Who discovered this reaction? Sabatier-Sanderson scientist. So therefore this reaction is called as Sabatier-Sanderson reaction. So what is mean by Sabatier-Sanderson reaction? When alkene and alkyne, that is the unsaturated hydrocarbon, When unsaturated hydrocarbon, that is alkene and alkyne, is heated with the hydrogen gas in the presence of ranilidine catalyst at about 453 to 473 Kelvin gives alkane, is known as Sabatier-Sanderson reaction. Have you got? What is meant by Sabatier-Sanderson reaction? When unsaturated hydrocarbon is heated with the hydrogen gas in the presence of ranilidine catalyst at about 453 to 473 Kelvin gives alkane, is the final product. This reaction is called as Sabatier-Sanderson reaction. Okay, so the another examples of the Sabatier-Sanderson reactions we will see in the next video.